Hello everyone! Today we're going to show you how to create and enhance your images using the Generate Image feature inside Project Dream. You can also turn your viewport previews into quick drafts using reference images. Start by navigating to Generate Image using this icon on the list. Let's start by walking through the different settings we have. You'll find at the very top the list of image models you can use. We recommend using the latest model available. Let's choose our image. You can drop your render or photo, or grab the viewport directly from your 3D software. You can use the viewport from any 3D software. If you're going to use the viewport, we recommend doing some basic cleanup first. Remove the helpers and unwanted objects from it. Transform any proxies or scatters to a full mesh view. You can also turn on color mode or show the textures in the viewport. This will help the software to interpret the image better. Assign a background or blue color to the viewport. Now you can send it to Project Dream using the Grab Viewport feature. In the prompt box, describe what you see on the image and what you want to add. For things you don't want, avoid hard negatives. Instead, use the negative prompt box to describe the elements that you don't want to appear on the image. There are two language models that you can use to enhance your prompts automatically. We recommend that users write this prompt manually and then use these tools to enhance the result. Creativity controls how far the AI wanders. At 30%, it respects the source image. At 100%, it may generate bold new elements. Resemblance locks down a structure. Select this parameter higher when you need more faithfulness. You can also use the built-in presets to test different settings. It's always helpful to spawn small variations of the same prompt in order to see which one works best. Change one slider at a time and generate multiple options. Tiny tweaks, huge payoffs. You can generate images already using only these parameters, but let's use a few more options to get even better results out of our viewport. You can fuse your prompt and viewport with a reference. This is the best approach to get more interesting results when using a viewport. You can use your own images or use Project Dream's beautiful library to borrow the mood, materials, and color palette from another image. You can search according to different topics or bring random images to inspire yourself. You can choose between three different options to use your reference image. Light mode will apply only the lighting and mood, but on heavy mode, the model will start including visual elements and materials from the reference as well. 50% of influence usually works well on any reference type. You can increase it with light creativity settings and lower it if your images start to show artifacts. When using a reference, include the desired mood, time of day, season, or weather effects on your prompt. You can use the feature Describe Image and Mood to get an automatic prompt based on the reference and input image. Using the reference mood tool, you can iterate quickly between different lighting and color palettes and speed up your concept process. In this other example, we have a finalized render that we want to enhance. I'm going to create a new image using the touch-up or light presets. Using a generated prompt here is perfectly fine. The change won't be that evident. Now that I have an image that I like, I'm going to send it to the creative upscaler. We always recommend to use the AI pass as another layer in Photoshop to enhance the final look of the image. Drop the AI output on top of your render and blend them as you wish for pixel-perfect control. This method will help us add detail exactly where we want it. As our final example, we will do some fast iterations over a finalized render using reference images from the gallery. We will use the default and medium settings for these iterations, combined with a light influence to get the mood and color palette. We can also generate the prompt automatically to make the workflow faster. These are some of the results that we've got. You can draw a mask over your image. Need to tweak only the sky? Paint over it, and the AI will only edit this area. You can increase the number of images the software will generate. If you like this image, you can further modify it by sending the results back as an input image using the Create Variations button. Or you can reuse the prompt, settings and input image anytime later using the Copy to Input feature. Once your image is created, you can compare originals and variants. From here, you can send the result to any Project Dream tool. For example, we can send it to the Creative Upscaler to get the best quality and enhance out the details on this image. you can rate your images, filter them, or switch to the gallery view. Once your image is upscaled, you can add it to the public showcase so others can see your work on the showcase tab. Now, you have all the tools to take your images to the next level. Experiment, compare models, and see where your creativity takes you. Until next time, happy dreaming!